Hello, good evening. Welcome. Welcome to Rangers Radio and this build up to European tie home to Bromby. Join myself, Fox, here on the show tonight. It's my mucker. Yes, my mucker, the Fox. Evening, Fox.
Evening, upstairs. Need to get used to this, no going to games. It's breaking my heart.
Oh, I'm sure things will change as you develop. I'm glad to see you get some new athletic gear today, jogging stuff and that. I'm proud of you, mate. Proud of you.
I like to kid myself on for a wee while, mate.
Yes, all made by Castor, mate. Yes, a walking advert you'll be for Castor. What a man. Right, Fox, I believe you've got the team.
I have indeed. The team is McGregor in goal. Back four of Tavener, Goldson, Balogun and Barisic. A middle three, if it's 4-3-3, we're going, is Lundstrom, Davis, Naribo. And up front, Hadji, Ruth and Morelis. Substitutes are McLaughlin, McCrory, Bassey, Patterson, Bakuna, Wright, Kelly, Fashion Jr. and Scotty Arfield.
Okay, good to see Arfield on the bench, mate. What's your thoughts on the team, mate?
It'll all depend on how we line up. I was hoping we would go 4-2-3-1, which we possibly still could do. But it looks on paper as if it's a 4-3-3.
Here's a question for you, Fox. If you played with that one up front, would you rather have Morelis playing on the space and Roof right up top as a finisher, or would you play Alfie there?
I would play Alfie myself.
And have Roof try to provide?
Roof, I would go 4-2-3-1, which I said last night. With Morelis up front, Aribo, Hadji and Roof sitting in behind him, mate. And Lundstrom and Davis sitting as our defensive midfielders.
Okay. I think got a message for Southside. He had Sakala in his team, so that's 56 attempts, and he's not got one right yet.
Well, I don't think many. Well, maybe some people would have got that team right. I was certainly out with one.
Mm-hmm. I think I had Sakala in my team. Yeah,
I had Wright in place of Ruth. That was my difference.
Well, I think we'll get these phone lines open, see if people want a massive game for us, folks. Must win, no lose. I don't know how you. I see it's a must win, if I'm being honest, yeah.
That is a must win. Yeah. A must win, because if we don't beat them tonight, I think we'll finish bottom of the group. I think Bromby have already got a point, if they know.
Yes.
So if they beat us home and away, that's the end of it, mate, isn't it?
Right.
And that point could be absolutely vital that they go in the draw away. What do you call them?
Sparta Prague.
Sparta Prague, yep.
Mm. All right, we've got the phone lines open, so let's hear from you.
Why don't you give us a call on 0141 356 1972? It's your show, it's your platform. Let's hear from you.
For the people just coming in, Fox, give us a team.
The team is McGregor in goal, Tavener, Goldson, Balogun and Barisic, Lundstrom, Davis, Naribo, Hadji, Ruth and Morelis. Substitutes are McLaughlin, McCrory, Bassey, Patterson, Bakuna, Wright, Kelly, Fashion Jr. and Scotty Arfield. Okay. And usually have two goalkeepers in the substitute spence, isn't
it? I think it's to do with the homegrown rule, isn't it? The homegrown rule.
Possibly.
Yeah. Yeah, Stephen Kelly on the bench, Scotty Arfield for midfield, Bakuna, Patterson Bassey cover the back four, and the Fashion Sakala for up front, yeah. We're not sure the goalkeeper in front on the bench.
No,
right, okay, so it's definitely a four. You could go 4-4-2 with that, some people might like that, I don't think so, I don't see anything that intimates that the manager's going to do that. But four, and then I think for me it's Lundstrom, Davis, and Aribo in midfield. I think that's no Hadji's position personally, Fox.
No, I mean, I would honestly, I would like to see the same way we played against Hearts in the first half, with the two sitting midfielders and the four up front, Aribo, Hadji, Ruth, and Morelis all in the attacking positions.
Mm-hmm.
I think Joe Aribo is a fantastic player, but I think he's more dangerous in and about the box than he is in midfield.
I agree, but I think the lack of numbers in there, but the option you've got is you bring Scott or Bakunin on and push him up front. Yeah?
Yep, aye.
Yeah, and obviously substitutes could play a part tonight because I think you're back to five in Europe, aren't you?
We are. I think he did say in his press conference that all his strikers would play a part in this game, so expect Wright to come on as well. So that's about it, mate.
Yeah. We'll see what it takes us. I think we should win. I'm just going to get the price for the bookies, the odds, mate. But I think we'll be joined by Cal. Evening, Cal.
Good evening, Ox. How's things?
Good to hear from you, mate. How are you?
Oh, no bad. Heard the team play. He's lacking pace.
Up front?
You know, I just think we're lacking pace. Our passing's going to have to be spot on tonight, you know.
Mm-hmm.
There can't be any stupid long boys no going anywhere, you know what I mean?
I keep the long boys low.
Aye. Oh, they've got to be shorter in 2 feet, or at least in reaching distance, because I don't think we'll get any pace up front. I mean, I like Hadji, but he's no pace.
No, I think I think Fox in the past has pointed out maybe that's how we got Hadji. If you put Scott
pace in it, he would be too dear for us.
Aye, if I've been really honest, because the boy's got ability and that pace would make him at a different level. But
aye, listen, you can't get any more pace. You can only get so much more pace. Usually be losing weight, but I don't think he's getting any loss.
No.
The other thing is,
yes.
I've not been feeling too great in the last couple of weeks. I didn't phone, but I'm getting fed up here, and we've got two players for every position. We've got two players for every position. We seem to buy in projects, you know what I mean? We've got nobody that comes right into the squad and slots in.
Well,
and I think we are sort of suffering with that, Ox. You know?
I think
good enough players, but we're sort of suffering for that.
I think we've maybe added to the quality of the squad, but whether you've added to the quality of the first team, only time will tell. But
aye. So
far, after having a slow start, and if there's a good game today in the night,
I didn't see it in Saturday because it's not allowed in England. I watched in the computer box here this. It was just wee things telling you Rangers are attacking, their Hearts are attacking, throwing in that, you know, on the screen.
Aye.
But the commentary was there. But the commentary was for Rangers TV 2 minutes behind real time.
All right.
I had a sore head for about an hour after it, but that was it was because of the result and things. But I hope we do right tonight. I hope I've got 1-0 nothing, 2-1, usual. A bridge issue, this is.
Cal, Rangers are 2-5.
I know that.
The draw is 15-4 and 13-2. So, Fox, the bookies have got us quite big favourites.
Well, the bookies do that. It's a load of money that comes on for British betting, doesn't it? It doesn't
exactly
really give any real justice to the two teams that's playing. I think we'll need to watch Brøndby tonight. Coached by former Denmark under-21 coach Fredriksen, who's a very adventurous coach, mate. He plays a normal 3-5-2, high-pressing game. And I think they'll try and take the game and try and put us out of the competition tonight. We need to be on our toes at all times tonight.
Yeah, we need to retaliate first, Cal. We need to retaliate first.
I think we can date them, but that's optimism, you know. It's just worrying the way we're playing with a lack of concentration, should I say, it seems to be.
Well,
and no seeing out games that we should be able to see it.
That's one way of putting it. We've also been joined by William. Evening, William.
Evening, boys. I just think people are being a wee bit too negative. I think there's definitely a team going to get a doing off us. It's coming, and hopefully the night's a night. I don't think the team's... I don't really see where he could have changed what he's put in. Bringing Davis in, I don't know where he's going to play him. Is he going to play him on the left?
That's interesting.
Is he going to play Lundstrom through the middle? Who's going to be the middle man? With the way Lundstrom's been playing, you've got to play him through the middle, surely.
I think that Lundstrom will get moved and Davis will start.
I think that would be the wrong thing to do. I think I would rather leave Lundstrom in and move Davis across. And then up front, who else would you have brought in? Do you know what I mean? It's,
personally,
I who else would you have brought in?
I would have played Ruth Morelos and Sakala, personally.
Sakala?
Just because of the pace. But
I get that, but I think Aribo does brilliant in European nights. I think that's very come to life.
If you listen to the show, you'll be surprised at this, William. I would have took Kadju, brought him on as a substitute.
I can understand that. He is a big impact player, isn't he? So I do understand that. But I do think there's too much doom and gloom just now in the Rangers support, and I hope tonight the Bears really get behind them. Unfortunately, I was working, so I can't get there, but the wee man's there. My boy's there.
What's his name? Give him a shout, Jack Allen. Right,
he'll be in the Union Bears dancing. So that's the one thing. I just hope the Bears stay behind them all the way, even if it takes 20, 25 minutes before they get their act together. They all just need to stay together. Sing my hearts out for them.
Fox, he's right. We're in it together. We're actually, believe it or not, Fox, we're sitting top of the league.
I know. You've never believed the way some people talk.
It's just after the way we played last season, William, and it was absolutely superb football, solid defence, great in attack, and we've been a wee bit slow to start this year, although, as you say, we're top of the league, still in all competitions, we can't complain.
The first half on Saturday was like watching last year, if only could have kept that going, but it's coming, I'm telling you, somebody's going to get hiding, hopefully it's tonight.
Do you think if that hiding came... The confidence comes back and it's a kick on. We don't want one-offs, if that makes sense, William.
Definitely. No, I think it's coming. And I think Gerrard believes the same. You heard him talking today. Somebody's going to take a down. It's only a matter of time to gel. But fingers crossed it's a right.
Does that make sense, Carl?
It's going to happen. We're going to have to gel. But this is almost the end of October. There can be no more excuses of no March fit or Matt Sharp. You know what I mean? It's a long time since we started playing football again.
I still think we're passing the ball a bit well. It's just that final edge. And because there's no final edge, it's relying on the back boys that have been caught out. But if you're up for nothing and you lose a goal like that the way that was happening last year, it wasn't a big deal. But because we're not really firing up front, we're not compensating for what's happening at the back.
No, that's what I'm saying, but we can't blame it all. It's just a slow start. We've been playing football. We should be much sharp, every one of them.
I know.
The only thing is, we're not seeing any players coming in that can hold a place.
Carl, see when you look at it, right, if you go through it, it's quite frightening, actually. McGregor and McLaughlin, both COVID. Goldston, COVID. Tav, COVID. Burner, injured. Balogun, injured. Hollander, injured. Kent's injured. Ryan Jack's injured. John Lundstrom had a slow start, came into the team. Hadji's had a COVID related thing. Morelos missed pre season, come back late. Wright's been injured.
Exactly. We got away with it last year. We could definitely get away with it last year that way, you know.
Aye, but
we've had it this year and we're still tapping the league.
I know, I'm fantastically happy we're tapping the league.
Morelos isn't fit. There's no way he's fit. He's not his pre season, so he's only going to get better as the season goes on.
Would you have chose Morelos tonight, William? Definitely, without a doubt, I would have played him with Ruth, though, Morelos and Ruth. Well, they're both in the team, it'll be interesting to see the lineup.
No, Ruth's on the subs, you know.
I'll get Fox to give you the team, Cam. We know you're not the quickest, we'll get Fox to give you the team.
That's all it is.
I know, mate, you're all but you. You're old, but you are beautiful. Go on, Fox. Come and
I can sing the rest of that, you know, but you'll get put off.
Your name's no Fox. Fox, give us the team.
The team is Alan McGregor in goal. Back four of Tavener, Goldson, Balogun and Barisic. A three in the middle of Lundstrom, Davis and Aribo. And up front, Hadji, Ruth and Morelos.
I thought Maruf was on the bench. Sorry.
There you go. We've done that specially for you, Carl.
Aye. It's Fox trying to fox me.
Get 5 minutes, you'll forgot again.
What do you mean, Father? Didn't it take as long as 5 minutes?
how are you lining that team up, William, with the personnel? You said the Lundstrom and Davis is a conundrum. What about Aribo Hadji? Well, where does Ruth and Morelos play?
We're going to play with the three of them up front and two wide, one in the middle. But sometimes I would love him to mix it up and play with two up front and one in a hole behind, and let the wing guys just take over that place. Do you know what I mean? Let Tavernier and Barisic just take that side. But it seems like he always wants to play that three and just let them swap about and play whatever they want. Sometimes I think I would like it to be... My problem is I'm used to McCoys and Haley, so I want that back. Do you know what I mean? That's how I grew up as a wee boy, so I'm always looking for that too. Do you know what
who
I mean?
Was that? McCoist and Haley?
Aye. Maybe that's what I'm always looking for that too.
Mm-hmm. My granddad told me
about each other.
My granddad told me about them.
Aye, so he did.
Oh dear. Don't ask me who I'm thinking of.
Hey, Fox, you're Gerard to lining that team up tonight, going, how are you lining it up? Oh, you there, Fox? No. Fell off his seat. I think we'll go with the three up front, and I think it'll be Hadji will get moved. No. Well, Hadji in the left. Can you see Hadji in the left, Fox?
No, I'm telling you, I think we'll start 4-2-3-1. I think right. Lundstrom and Davis will sit in the middle of the park, and the three in front of them will be Aribo, Hadji and Roof. With Morelos up front. I think the most interesting battle tonight will be with Morelos and their centre-half, Maxa, I think his name is, a two-footed player, quick in the ground, strong centre-half. He plays in the middle of a back three. He's very highly rated, this boy, and that'll be some tussle for Morelos, and I hope Alfie comes out on top.
There's perfect logic in what you say, Fox. Is normal, William.
Aye, I like that. The two Hodden is exactly what I was saying. Is who's going to play left and right. But if you do Hodden day two in the middle, it does free up that bit of the park for the forward boys. So I do like that.
Mhm. Fox,
bit more modern than I'm thinking.
4-4-2, mate. Is it?
Aye, that's it. Just get into them, man. Just get into them.
I get that, and it's a common theme that we have on the show, William, and I'll go to Carl with us, that people say we don't get enough players in the box, and if you think back to the Hibs game, all right, we're playing against 10 men, but we got the two goals when Morelos and Roof were playing up front.
Right, you just got to, I think tonight we've just got to, for the first minute, just go for it. Do you know what I mean? You've already lost the first two games, we've got to get something out of this, so just get your heads down and fucking get tore in. And the quicker they get tore into it, the quicker the crowd get into it. And once that starts, God knows what you can do, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Just go and fucking sorry.
Watch your language.
I know, sorry, I apologise, guys.
No, sorry, mate. I've never quite got it. But it's a big game, and you're right, the support can play a part. Carl?
I think what he said there was good. We've got to get guys in the box, and we need Morelos and Roof to work well together. But I think, as you're saying, it's going to be 4-3-5. You know what I mean? With the one up front, 4-3-2-1. You're going to have them up front, or whatever it is. I'm all mixed up with all this tactic talk. So I want George McLean and Jim Forrest up front, okay?
I'd rather have Lex McLean.
He wasn't as funny as you think.
4-2-3-1 was the fault. He's got Lundstrom and Davis sitting in front of the back four. They're the defensive mid, and then in front of him he's got Hadji in the right, Aribo in the left, Roof in the middle, and Alfie up top. That's the way Fox is setting up the team, Tal.
Oh, the other way around. He'll put Aribo in the right and Hadji in the left.
Right, I don't see, I've not seen Hadji often on the left. Yeah,
me neither, but I'd prefer Hadji sort of in the middle, but she's too fit.
The two of them will switch on right anyway, that's why he picks them, you know what I mean? The two of them will switch on right.
Lot of skill there with the two boys. I mean, Aribo and Hadji.
Aribo's got spaghetti feet, man. You don't know where he's going. The boy can turn the sections.
You're a big fan of Aribo, Fox, ain't you?
Oh, definitely. I love watching Joe Aribo. I've not seen him do such good close control at Rangers for a long, long time. He can create, he can score goals. Joe Aribo's one of my favourite players. We'll need to watch with our fullbacks tonight, because they pose a threat, by the way. I've got two up front, as Gerard called them, little and large. The boy Ewer has scored eight goals in 13 games so far this season, and he's usually saddled along beside Helland, a smaller player but tricky player. So Connor Goldson and Balogun will need to be on their toes tonight and watch these two. I think they'll try and hit us in the break tonight in the Springfield midfield. So I'm just hoping that we're wide awake for that, and we can control the game as we normally try and do.
I definitely think this will be like an old-school European game where they will sit back and try and hit us. I remember being a young boy and watching European nights at Ibrox and thinking Rangers were playing brilliant, and then 10 minutes they go getting beat 1-0. I just hope it's not that kind of night. They just get tore in and just keep going for it, you know what I mean? But that's my worry, is them breaking. Them just sitting back and breaking away for us, because sometimes we can be a wee bit too gung-ho.
I think this is a night to get the shooting boots on. I think that's where the problems lay. We've not scored enough goals, and then you put the defence under pressure, make mistakes, i.e. Allen on Saturday, and you lose a couple of points. But if you put them on the net, as Stevie G said, Fox, you take all that pressure.
That's been my problem in Europe this year. I think we've only scored three goals, including the Champions League outing. Morelos has scored two, and I think Steve Davis has scored one. So we haven't been scoring goals in Europe. We need to turn that trend around tonight and take the chances as they come.
Yep. For people just joining us once again, folks, people are always coming in. Give us a team. Nope. Off his perch, I'll give you. McGregor, Tavernier, Goldson, Balogun, Barisic, Lundstrom, Davis, Aribo, Hadji, Ruffin, Morelos. Substitutes, McLaughlin, McCrory, Bassett, Patterson, Bakuna, Wright, Kelly, Fashion Jr. and Scotty Arfield. Yeah. So
what's your thoughts on Balogun recently?
Okay, at times. Had obviously, you go back to the Celtic game, man of the match, but if you think about his performance in Prague, it wasn't great. I don't think he was bad on Saturday, it wasn't great, but to be fair, they weren't under a lot of pressure, apart from maybe 15 minutes of the match. They pretty much strolled at the first 60.
I definitely think what more confidence in the boy. I'm not saying his performances are getting much better, but after the Celtic game, I definitely think he's got a bit more confidence in himself. And long may it continue.
He's been a great signing for us, considering he was a free transfer. A great piece of business. Whether he can get us to the next level, whatever that level is, I don't know, but it'll always be fun when remembered, because he got the man of the match in an All Firm game, and he'll be remembered for it, wouldn't he?
Definitely, because he made that day.
Aye, he was absolutely superb right back, wasn't he? Right back.
I was standing loud when the team got announced, and the whole place was just like, oh no, Balogun's playing full back, oh no. But the sliding tackles he'd done all day were priceless, man. Outstanding.
I think a few Sartico awards, and he deserved the man of the match. I don't dislike the big one. I don't think he's as good a defender as Big Hollander, but I don't know if many are, because Big Hollander's just...
Big Hollander's just a boy, isn't he?
He just likes defending, didn't he?
That's great to see, but he's a great big player. I love him.
The only trouble we've got, mate, he's not in the park often enough. When you really dissect it, he's missed some amount of games. You know, he's very unlucky through injury. Cal?
I agree with that. That's probably how we've got him as well. You know, if he was sort of robust injury free, why, you know, why I don't think we would have him there. I've got a one point. I don't want to go on about it. Right. I watched Bayern last night.
Right.
Barisic is never going to play for Croatia again with that young boy they've got.
Is he Croatian?
He can play he's Sefnovic. It ends with IC or anyway his name. He can play left back or right back. Barisic will not be playing with Croatia again, I don't think.
Good player.
So that's good. It's quite good. But the other point was, African Cup of Nations coming up. If we don't get our injuries back, we are going to be threadbare.
Cal, if you look at about three of homework, we've talked about it on here. we stop for an early day game and we don't play for 3 weeks. It's only if Nigeria get to maybe the final that will really affect us.
Well, hopefully it won't affect us too much. I wouldn't want to see Rangers players playing badly for anything, but Nigeria doesn't bother me too much.
I don't like the colour of their strap, but I wish they play for Rangers.
Well, what about we'll Cedric Kitten? Have you seen the colour of his strip and what is going as a badge?
Oofed.
I've seen that team. I'm not going to mention what it is, but it's very reminiscent of puddle drinkers and things like that.
Oh, no, it's a Shamrock. It's not a fucking... Sorry.
You've won the traps easy, didn't you?
You put a bait out there, Cal.
I've landed a big one. Right, OK, boys, have a good time. Hope everything goes well. And if I'm not drunk, I might phone later. And no swear, by the way. I'm only swear. Promise to God.
Enjoy
hope to die.
It's interesting, Fox, about the setup of the team. Obviously, people were talking about maybe there was people mentioned Bassey coming in, Patterson coming in, but we're not surprised it's a tried and tested.
No. I've been even minded Patterson myself, and you know I'm a big Tav fan, but I think experience is going to make a big difference tonight. Both Barisic and Tavernier have got the experience, whereas Bassey and Nathan Patterson are still learning their trade. They'll get their chances, and they're coming up in the rest of the season. But tonight, I think, such an important game, it was better to go for experience for me.
I get that. And Patterson might get his chance. You never know. But I tried and tested. Tav's he's done things. If you think of that goal, who was that against when we played the pass and Barisic put it in? He appeared to heater it in. I'm trying to remember who was that against. Galatasaray, mate.
He got up well at the back post.
Nodded
at home. Yeah, I remember that.
He's had some great highlights. He's had his lowlights as well in Europe, but ultimately, he's a tried and tested, and I don't think it's a surprise to most that Stevie G's picked him, mate.
No, without a doubt, no. But then, see, the tonight, Ox, if we can get an early goal, I think that will settle us down and maybe help us on our way. If it goes a tight game to half-time, maybe we only seem to play one good half as it stands at the moment. So I'm hoping we go off to a flyer, maybe a goal after 15 minutes. Then we take control of the game and then maybe add to it later on in the game. I'm going for 2-0 tonight.
2-0, that'll do me.
And who's getting the goals for you? I'm going to go for Morelos, both goals.
And hopefully plays so. Forum's no true, but give himself a bit of confidence in front of goal.
I don't think he lacks confidence. He's just a great instinctual striker for me. Ruth takes that award on our side, but he's likely to do the unexpected. What he does do is normally he'll get his shot on target, but no placed into the goal the way Ruth can. You know. I'd say 90% of Alfie's shots are always on target. They might not be left and low down in the corner, but they're always in the target range, if you know what I mean.
Would you say that he just lacks a wee bit of finesse?
That's a good word for it, yes.
Yeah.
But his other all-round play is tremendous. The way he brings other players into the game, the way he can hold the ball up, win his free kicks high up the park when they're very important in European games. So him and Hadji are both capable of that, of getting his fouls up and running about the box, where hopefully we can take advantage of that tonight.
And does the European football suit Hadji because of the way the games are usually played?
Well, they're a wee bit more open than they are in Scotland for me. You know, we like it as packed defences all the time. And people complain because we play tippy-tappy football about the box. But if you're carrying the ball up to the 18-yard box and all you see is a mass of defenders, it's very difficult to put it through your mind to have a go, mate, when you think the shot will be blocked. So We do try and be intricate about the box. Sometimes it works for us, but most times it doesn't need the shot is blocked if it comes in from outside the box. John Lundstrom is the first player I've seen in a wee while that had a shot starting outside the post and curling in when he beat Craig Gordon playing against Hearts there.
And it's a big trend of modern football, that kind of shooting, isn't it?
Oh, without a doubt.
You know, I don't think you could have done it with a Tomlinson T-ball, could you?
No.
You know, particularly when it was wet. But I'm looking forward to see how Lundstrom does tonight, because if he was to rack up another man in a match performance, mate, we would have to put my stake in the ground and say he's arrived big style, eh?
He's been growing in confidence slowly but surely. He feels in control when he's got the ball. He's strong in the tackle as well, for winning balls back. And that goal just topped off his performances in the last few games. Terrific goal.
Mm-hmm. Are you happy to see Davis back?
Well, Steve Davis controls the game for us, doesn't he? He takes the ball off the defence. He's quick to move the ball forward when he gets it, bringing it out of defence. He's the go-to guy in any position for any player under pressure. And he's always willing and able to take the ball and get it away to another player. Great wee player, Steve Davis.
Right. Do you think at the start that he would be doing most of the sitting and encouraging John Lundstrom to join in it where possible, mate?
It's difficult to say, Ox, because we don't know how we're lining up tonight. I can see the two of them sitting in the middle of the park and try to dictate play. If we go to 4-3-3, can we get the work rate out of Aribo and Lundstrom left and right, Ox? Because they're heavy duty in a 4-3-3, and whether they two can cover the ground that they'll need to cover tonight, that'll be a big test for them.
I get where you're coming from, mate. It'll be really interesting to see how we line up. I think we know the back four. We know McGregor's in goals. After that, even you couldn't say with 100% confidence that Alfie's got to be number 9, because you just don't know, do you?
No, you do know. It could be Ruth. It could be any sort of formation up front. We'll just have to see. It's when we line up and we see how we're going to attempt to win the game, mate. It could change at times during the game, depending on how it's going. But the 4-2-3-1 definitely worked against Hearts in the first half, and it's the best we've played all season for me.
That's how you're keeping it going then, because you believe that we showed that we got a bit of form back against the Hearts, even though ultimately we lost a goal in the last minute, and you want to keep going and hopefully improve. Is that your thinking?
Well, it was, as you were saying earlier, it was a case of getting bodies into the box, and we certainly done that against Hearts. We had people arriving all the time in the box, and we did put good balls into the box but failed to take our chances. Craig Gordon had a few exceptional saves, and that's the way the cuckoo crumbled on Saturday, mate. They eventually score with a mistake from one man you don't expect to. And that was Alan McGregor.
Aye, and that's football, isn't it?
That's football, yep.
That's football.
I think that's the story of your season so far. Was last season, the breaks in the ball inside both boxes fell to us. And in defence, we managed to clear them. And in attack, we managed to score them. But this season, it seems to be that the break of the ball sometimes in vital positions has went against us. And we've either lost a goal or failed to take a chance.
Aye. Bit of luck, Fox. Bit of luck sometimes make a big difference, eh?
All teams need a bit of luck, and especially in Europe. And hopefully we get one or two wee bits of luck tonight. I'll take two goals off of Alfredo's backside tonight. That'll do me.
I just wish he'd slide in with that one on Saturday with his backside and put it in the net, you know?
I've watched that back, mate, and I still don't know whether he expected the defender to block the ball coming across to him, or he didn't get a good enough view and never seen it to till it was too late and just died or stretched out for it and missed the ball for me, you know.
Maybe you're doing that thing you talked about, luck.
Aye, luck.
You know, you fall and you're lying there and it hits you and goes in, mate.
Aye, these things happen.
You know, that's just the game. Listen, I think the bookies are the far away. I think we should be. This is a team we should beat, Ibrox, and if we beat them tonight, I'm hoping that we can go there and win as well, Fox, to really get us back into the group. I'm not saying we're going to win it. I'm just saying that it's good to get the respect of teams in Europe, and also the financial rewards help the club out, yeah?
Aye, it means a lot to a club getting. Although if you can stay in Europe, even dropping into the lower competition, there's no much between the money and the prize money, Ox. It's not as big as people think it is. And to stay in Europe today after Christmas would be a big bonus to us, the fans who like to see teams coming to Ibrox from foreign shores. And it keeps the interest up.
Some people would be happy if we came out all together, eh?
Well, the league is so important this year because of the big prize at the end of it. But we like to win every game, Hawks. We don't depend on just hanging about in competitions, you know.
You're in it to win it, folks. Or try and win it, eh?
In it to win it's a good saying.
All right, you've went for 2-0, the Rangers. I'll go for 1 more than that. Yeah, there you go. You've talked me into it.
3-0, oh God. That would be a big bonus night for
You've
us.
You've talked me into it, folks. A bit of positivity. Well, you'll be right. Why are you doom and gloom? Let's go
It's no doom and gloom. It's just realistically looking at our chances and the way we've played all season. And if Saturday first half didn't give people a bit of hope and a bit of a glimpse of how well we can play, well, hopefully we turn round and show them tonight, over the 90 minutes, that we are improving.
Because we are. The people,
The people, aye.
Yeah. Right, okay. Last one for you, then I'll have a wee shout-out, and then we'll have a tune. Is that all right?
Aye.
Right, been a pleasure, mate.
Oh, thank you very much.
I'll tell you Enjoy what, it. That Castor gear, you should maybe think about taking up that modelling, mate. It really suits you.
Aye. The pensioners range.
No many people of your ilk could carry that off, but you do. You look pucker in that, mate. Pucker.
Yeah, I think it's the bow tie language that kind of sets it off, mate.
No many people your age. That Garcia hoodie you've got in that, I can't believe it. Smart as you are. Smart as some man. Right, give us a shout out.
Come on, the Bears. That's all I want to say. Come on, the Bears.
If you're listening and you're making your way to the Ibrox, get right behind the team. The team needs you. We need you. Come on, the Rangers. This has been Rangers Radio. Thanks to Fox, William and Cal. Thanks to Old School Boy for doing the technicals. We'll be back approximately 15 minutes after the final whistle celebrating a Rangers victory, Fox.
Let's hope so.
Take it away, Old School Boy.
Steven Gerrard, 255, he'll lead us all the way. Scalping the terms at home at Ibrox, and even in the piggery, we've got the battle fever on until the game is won. The spirit of those drift will carry on. Let's go. outside the blue sea of Ibrox. He'll cheer you on to victory, as we did in Barcelona, and the first of nine at Pettodrie. We've got their battle fever on until the game is won. The spirit of this truth will carry on. We've got their battle fever on until the game is won. The spirit of this truth will carry on.